Before we get into today's video, I've got three things for you. Number one, if you want to get a notification whenever we post a new video, make sure you ring that bell. Number two, there's a TCG Player affiliate link in the show notes. After clicking that link, every purchase you make on tcgplayer.com helps support this channel. Number three, you'll also find a link to our Patreon where you can support us directly. And now, kick back and enjoy the show.
What's up, Spikes? We're back. I'm coming at you from the beautiful Spike Feeders World headquarters here in Winnipeg, Manitoba, but the other three people that you see on your screen are not. We are now officially, we've burned through all of our pre-recorded games that we recorded before COVID-19 was a serious issue that required us to hard quarantine in our homes. So we're trying something a little bit different now. We've set up the rest of the Spikes with cameras that will hopefully allow us to record fairly good quality gameplay over Spell Table. So that's the client that we're using right now to share our webcams. And it's a great service. It allows you to track your life total, show who your commanders are, your commander damage, all that fun stuff. We are using a couple tricks behind the scenes. Stay tuned for more information on that to be able to share our face cams in addition to our boards. So without further ado, we're going to kick things off. I am going first today. I'm playing Bosch Iron Golem. I played this a little while ago in one of our games. We might have clickbaited you a little bit in terms of how much work this deck did, but we're playing fringier decks this time, so I'm hoping that I'll be able to get a little bit more action going. It's a very artifact-heavy deck. We're playing lots of eggs. Like, we're playing zero-drop artifacts, trying to draw as many cards as we can. It's got some Snoop lines, and it's also got some KCI lines. So that's what I'm trying to do today.
Nice. Hi, everybody. Alex again. Today, we started with a question, what if Boros could try to play CEDH? And this is what the Discord and I came up with. It's an Aurelia the Warleader deck that is focused around Helm of the Host. Lots of stacks effects, lots of hate bears. I'm just trying to do resource denial until I have the resources I want. We also decided to throw in some Kiki Jiki combo. So, yeah, we'll see if
we can get one of those to work. Right. Yeah. You're in red. You can play Kiki Jiki.
Did you guys see that new card from Commander Legends that finally combos with Kiki Jiki?
Yeah.
I can't believe it's taken them this long. That's crazy.
Jan, what do you got going on?
So I'm Jan. Today I am playing Kalamax the Storm Sire. It is one of my favorite CDH decks that I've ever built. We're basically just going to be copying spells and trying to keep track of what we're actually doing, because there's a surprising amount of math involved in this.
And I'm playing Wurt the Raid Mother. So this is a Divergent Transformations deck, but surprisingly, or unsurprisingly maybe, because Wurt has the keyword Conspire in her text box, a lot of spells can act like a Divergent Transformation. So we've got quite a suite of polymorph-esque spells, and we're going to hope to assemble the only two creatures in the deck as some sort of infinite combo. No spoilers on what the creatures are, but one of them might be Kiki Jiki.
Nice. Well, without further ado, we're going to throw it over to the face cams and we'll see you after the intro. Okay, I'm going to start us off by drawing a card. I'm going to play a Bloodstained Mire and I'll pass the turn.
Alrighty. So we'll draw for turn. Chuckle a little to ourselves. We'll play this Plains. We'll play a Mana Crypt. No responses.
No, go.
Okay, we'll add two to our mana pool. Cast Isochron Scepter.
Any responses? Like, fine. I'm gonna fetch in response to the Isochron Scepter cast.
Okay.
I have no response.
Yeah.
Off Bloodstained Mire, I'm gonna get a snow covered mountain.
Very nice. Mm-hmm. Any responses once again?
Nope.
Got nothing.
All right. Isochron Scepter enters the battlefield. When it comes into play, I'm removing this card. Any stifle effects, I guess?
Nope.
All right.
Nope.
I'm going to assume not. We'll put Angel's Grace under Isochron Scepter.
Angel's Grace?
Oh, no.
Un petit peu.
What do we do with Angel's Grace under Isochron Scepter?
Not lose the game ever.
Yeah, never die, I guess.
Again.
And then we'll play this Chrome Mox, which I also assume resolves.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And exile this Aven Mindcester under our Chrome box.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Get a little spike to remind us to flip a coin, and we'll pass a turn.
Well, that was kind of impressive. I'm going to draw a card. And I'm going to play a Verdant Catacombs. And yeah, I'm just going to pass the turn. Or no, I'm going to crack this.
It's done.
I'm going to get a Taiga. And with that, I'm going to tap one, and I'm going to cast a Mana Bolt.
Mm-hmm.
Not quite as impressive as Alex. Then I'm going to pass the turn.
All right. I'm going to draw. I'm going to play a Bloodstained Mire. And I'm going to crack it, going to 39. And I'm going to get this Taiga. And then I'm going to cast a Faithless Looting.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. Any effects?
Nope.
Nope.
All righty, draw two. Oof. I'm going to discard this Red Elemental Blast and this Pyroblast.
not the best at this table.
Not doing much there, yeah.
Yeah, pass the turn.
Okay, I'll draw a card. I'm going to play a Snow-Covered Mountain, and I would like to cast a Dockside Extortionist.
Ooh.
One, ooh. Two, three.
And one four. From Jan is four, yeah.
Does that resolve?
I'm good.
Yeah, no effects.
Yeah, no effects.
How many artifacts were there?
Four.
Four.
Four. I would like to make four treasures. Let's get a green one here. Four treasures.
Seems good.
I'm just going to pass the turn.
Alrighty. In my upkeep... I have to roll for Mana Crypts. We're going to do evens or damage. That's a two, so I'm going to take three. Go to 37. Card.
Where's your red mana, Alex?
It's in my deck.
It's a good place
exactly
for it to
where
be.
We want it to be. Yeah.
I say this is. Isn't this what you want overall? Yeah. Tap three to play a Vryn Wingmare.
Ooh.
Yeah. That's the turn.
What the heck does that thing do?
Non-creature spells. Cost one more.
That's probably fine. Okay. All right. So I'm going to untap. Draw this card here. I'm going to play a Waterlogged Grove. All right. So, do three colorless. Spend a colorless and a red, and I will cast my own Dockside Extortionist.
Oh boy.
Hmm.
Four.
So it'll make eight, right?
Treasures or artifacts.
Right.
Yeah.
So seven.
Why seven?
Because I don't count my own.
Oh, right.
So, yeah, so Alex has three and then you have four.
So the question is, do I want to sacrifice any treasures?
That is the question. I have no effects, just so we're clear.
I will sacrifice two treasures in response to the Dockside Extortionist.
Okay.
What are they adding? What colors?
Red.
Okay. So I will get five treasures then, assuming I counted right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Now, what do I want to do with these five treasures?
Pass the turn.
Yeah, that's the right answer.
I got to spend them all before Elliot casts his Dockside.
I only play two creatures. Neither of them are Dockside Extortionist.
Oh, that seems... Okay, well, let's let's crack two of them. We'll make a red and a blue. And we'll cast Kaza, Royal Chaser.
Mm-hmm. So the next spell costs X less to cast. That's got haste. Interesting.
It has flying haste. It is a 1/2. Currently, it offsets the cost of the Vryn's Wingmare.
Yep. For one spell.
For one, for the next instant or sorcery spell I cast.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm going to pass there.
Okay, I'm going to untap. I'm going to draw for my turn. Not great. I'm going to play this Gemstone Cavern. Yeah, very sad. And then paying for it because of the Vryn Wingmare, I will cast this Lotus Petal. Pass the turn.
Yep. Lotus Petal doesn't seem as good if you have to pay for it.
Yeah, but no, I didn't get a choice, really, hey?
Yeah.
Definitely not. I will play this Snow-Covered Mountain as my land for turn. I think I'm just going to play this 3-mana Arcane Signet. And I'll pass the turn.
Alrighty. So we'll untap. Got a trigger for my mana crypt. Evens our damage. That's an odd. We stay at our life total. We draw a card. Oh, do we want to do anything this turn? Elliot, you got no blockers, right?
I got no blockers.
That's good. I'll keep my other blocker, though. Pass turn.
Oh, okay. Exciting. Well, I'll take one off. There's an animal. Draw this card here. Well, I'll tap this Taiga to cast a Birds of Paradise. Mm-hmm. And pass the turn. Exciting times.
I'll untap, and I will draw a card. I'm going to play this Forbidden Orchard. And then... who gets a spirit?
Pick me.
Well, you already have 3 creatures. Don't be greedy.
I'm not a creature deck. Well, or a combat deck.
I mean, is anybody here? Well, Alex is, I guess. Okay. Alex, Jim, yeah. Jim, you can have a spirit.
Me?
Yeah. I have to pay 3 mana for this Cathartic Reunion. And as an additional cost to cast it, I would like to discard this Guttural Response and this Ricochet Trap.
Seems like good choices overall.
And then I'll draw 3 cards. Okay. Those are some better spells, at least. I will just pass the turn.
Okay. I'll untap. Draw. Play this Snow-Covered Mountain. I'm going to cast a 2-mana Faithless Looting. If that resolves, I will draw 2. And discard Guild Globe and Inventor's Fair. Sorry. Snow-Covered Mountain.
Seems reasonable.
And then I'm going to move to combat. And I will attack Alex for 1.
You got it. I'll go to 36.
Then I'll pass the turn.
Elliot, if you're passing out those spirits, I could really use one. Just throw that out there.
We just decided you're the combat deck. You get no spirits.
Yeah, give me a spirit, Elliot. I'll attack Alex with it.
Probably going to keep giving him to Jim.
Now we're starting to get into trouble territory on the old mana colors. All right, what are we going to do? We should run that out. Yeah, we should definitely run that out.
Oh, I don't like this at all.
5 for Helm of the Host.
Oh.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Any response?
Nope.
Nope, no effects.
All righty. Pass the turn.
All right. On tap. I will take one off of my mana vault. 137. Draw this card. Ooh. That doesn't do anything. Well, I guess I'm going to tap for a red, take a pain for a blue. One, go down to 1 treasure for 5 mana, and I will cast a Ral, Storm Conduit.
Ooh. Yeah.
That's and you paid the 1 for Vryn Wingmare, yeah?
I did. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Sounds good.
Yeah, right. I have no effects. unfortunately, because that might kill us.
Pick up two scry one. Oh, that's rough. Okay, I'm going to put that on the bottom.
All right.
And I will pass the turn.
Okay, I will untap. Draw for my turn. I'm going to play this Verdant Catacombs, and I'm going to crack it, going to 38. So I'm going to get this Stomping Ground and go to 36 here, because I'm going to have it enter play untapped. And then it's kind of sad, but I think I have to just pay 3 to try to Hull Breach Alex's Helm of the Host. There are no enchantments in play.
I like that. I'm passing priority.
Alex, priority?
Well, I can't read Hull Breach because the card fetcher isn't coming up. What's it say?
Destroy target artifact.
Okay. Yeah, I think that's probably good.
Yeah, I feel like not stopping that because Helm on the Wingmare is bad for us.
Very, very bad for us. Yeah, true. Yep, I don't want to give anybody a spirit this turn, so pass.
Okay.
Takes my helm, doesn't give me a spirit.
Yeah. Wow, Elliot.
Draw. Play this Inventor's Fair as my land for turn.
More like.
Nope. We don't do that here anymore.
We don't do that.
Not like this.
In the virtual space.
Yeah, yeah. Not now. Not like this.
Save the good jokes for the studio.
Can I get a quick check, Alex, on what's in your graveyard?
Helm of the Host.
That's it? And Jan, just a fetch land?
Just a Verdant Catacomb.
Elliot?
Lots of stuff. Hull Breach, 2 fetch lands, Ricochet Trap, Guttural Response, Pyroblast, Red Elemental Blast, Faithless Looting, and Cathartic Reunion.
Holy.
Yeah, you want some Elemental Blasts, pal?
Yeah, like maybe.
And their ilk actually drew so all 4 of them.
Yeah. I'm so happy you discarded them, Elliot, because I have a handful of blue cards.
Hey, man. That's fine.
Okay, I'm going to pay 4 mana to flashback my Faithless Looting.
Mm-hmm. I think I'm probably going to do that next turn.
Yeah, that's fine with me.
That's good. Okay, yep. I'll draw 2. I'm going to discard Crystal Vein and Great Furnace.
This man's has too many lands.
Must be and
I wouldn't mind drawing a land.
And I think I'm just gonna attack Alex for 1.
Ah!
Got him.
Almost had him. Yeah. Okay. Then I'll pass the turn.
Right up. Okie dokie. Looking for evens for damage. That's an even. Ouch.
Ouchie.
We're 32. Spirit's doing work. All right. Draw a card.
Yep. Oof. I feel like it's a white mana source.
Yeah.
You are correct. Jim, you got any flyers?
I do not.
Take 2.
Rude. I would like to declare no blockers.
I accept this proclamation and substitute it with a pass.
All right. I'm going to untap and take 1 off of my mana vaults. I guess I'll take 1 off of this. Waterlog Grove. Cast a Sylvan Library.
Ooh. I have no effects, but I really wish you had that enchantment in play when I cast this Hull Breach.
Sorry, all right. Y'all got really scared about my Helm of the Host.
I'll put this on the bottom. All right, and go ahead, Elliot.
Alrighty, I will untap. Draw for my turn.
Yeah, Helm of the Host is scary, Alex. It's
I get it.
It's the second half of your deck name. Aurelia Helm.
Yeah, oh, true. That's not referring to that helm. It's actually referring to Helm's Deep, which is from the lore of...
Yeah, that's not even a magic card. You could say Helm of Eldra.
I hate everything that's happening. I'm going to play an Emergence Zone as my land for turn.
Nice.
All right. That's 6, if I can do math, which hopefully I can. So, Jim, you may have another spirit, and I have to sack this Lotus Petal. But I'm going to attempt to cast Wart the Raid Mother.
I gotta read this thing now.
Yeah, when she ETBs, I get 2 1/1s that are red and green Goblin Warriors, and then each red or green instant or sorcery I play has Conspire.
Ooh. Interesting.
Sounds illegal.
Yep.
Alrighty, I will make 2 red and green goblins. Can you see that they are both red and green like I can?
Ooh. I get it.
Yep. Pass the turn.
Oh, I'm Elliot. I have colorblindness. Oh.
That's racist, Alex.
Oh, my bad. It's on me.
Go ahead, Jim.
Elliot, in your end step.
No, don't do it.
No, I won't do it.
Hey, it worked.
Untap, draw a card.
A quick question: what does Inventor's Fair trigger on?
Oh yeah, it's triggers on three artifacts on upkeep, which I do have.
Cool. Is it 3? Wow, I thought it was 4.
Yeah, I just figured I'd head off the YouTube comments there.
Gotcha. We're gonna have enough about our janky setup here anyway.
Seriously,
we're doing our best, guys.
Yeah, no, but thank you for commenting.
Yeah, thanks for watching. Thanks for commenting. We appreciate the patronage. That's not the word. It might be the word.
Don't forget to smash that MFing subscribe button and hit the bell.
Yeah.
Just commit an absolute war crime on that bell.
Okay. Bring it back just a little bit.
Like, we're not that desperate for subs. Come on.
So... Jan, what does Ral do when it ults? Is that the extra turns one?
Doesn't have an ult. So Ral Stormcaller has the static ability of whenever I cast or copy an instant or sorcery spell, Ral Stormcaller deals 1 damage to target opponent or planeswalker.
Plus two
to scry one, and then I can -2. When you cast your next instant or sorcery spell this turn, copy that spell. You may choose new targets.
I'm considerably less concerned about that than I was. I know that there's a combo with it, but
yeah, no, it's like it's a finisher.
But yeah, right, yeah, yeah. If he infinite forks, we die because he has that in play. But
yeah,
right. But it on its own, not super spooky.
Okay, then I'm going to tap 8. I will sacrifice both of my treasures.
Oh no!
And cast Bosh. Bosh is a 6/7 trampler, has a 4 mana activated ability that says sacrifice an artifact. Bosh deals damage equal to the sacrificed artifact's converted mana cost to target creature or player. I'm going to assume that this has been errated to say any target.
Look, there's been a new printing of it, so there should be updated. I feel like it would be any target.
Yep, any target.
Sweet. And then if that resolves, I'm going to move to combat. And I will attack Alex for 2.
He looks so surprised.
And then I'll pass the turn.
Alex, where's your swords? Where's your paths?
For the 1/1 spirits?
Yeah, no kidding. So we're going to take 3 damage, go to 27.
Ooh, the clock is kind of real.
It is absolutely ticking on us today. I'm not happy about it. All right.
Oh, you hate to see it.
I do. I do hate to see it.
Sorry, who hates to see it?
Alex. Yeah, I'm having a great time with my friends and also
this is
Jan.
Some aggressively bad RNG. But anyway, we're going to take the Dream in the Mirror. We're going to just hit Jim right back in the face.
Okay.
I'm glad other people were talking so that Jan evidently didn't hear me.
Oh, I did. I did, Elliot.
All right, I guess I passed the turn.
All right. Take one damage off this mana vault. Okay, am I going to take 8?
It's almost always correct to just suck. Ooh. 8.
These are good cards.
You hate to see it.
Yeah.
Sorry, who hates it? Wait.
Is that the next spike on the mic? Who hates it to see it?
Yeah, who hates to see it? I'm your spike on the mic. Thanks for talking to me about who hates to see it.
I'm actually only just going to take. Yeah, well.
Combat damage on the table.
Yeah, combat damage is kind of on the table. And like non-infinite Bosch, I guess.
Yeah. I'm not super thrilled about everything that's going on. Okay. I'm going to do this in the right order. I'm going to tick Ral down.
Uh-oh. Yeah.
I'm going to play 1, 2. I'm going to cast a Pongify.
Targeting?
So it's going to trigger Ral, copy it. One's going to target Bosch, one's going to target Wart.
Wow.
And then you're going to... and then Elliot, you're going to take... No, GM, take 2 damage off of Ral's trigger ability.
Okay. Is it 2?
It's once for casting the Pongify and another time for copying the Pongify.
Yeah, it's 1 damage twice.
What? Yeah, it's 1 damage twice. It's cast or copy.
That's crazy.
So, apes.
Yeah. Make some apes, I suppose. My wart will go to my command zone, I guess. There's no reason for it not to.
And yeah, I guess from there, I'm going to pass the turn.
I've got an ape. Dancing smart depends. Okay. I will untap. Doo-doo. I will draw. Hi-ya! Wow, that card is... not good with the effects that are in play currently. So I will pay a green with this Stomping Ground and 1 with this Gemstone Caverns to put a Utopia Sprawl on my Taiga. It's a little sad, but you know, it's actually not the worst thing in the world.
If it gets there, it gets there.
Yeah.
And then 1, 2, 3. I could pay 4 to flashback this Faithless Looting, huh?
Costs. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Yep.
I would have to give somebody a spirit again, but I've got an ape now. Stop pointing at yourself, Alex. You're first.
How am I first? I've been mana screwed for 3 turns.
Ah, you know, that's not my problem.
I know it's my problem. I'm just saying, give me a spirit.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 right now. So if I cast this instead, it would make it 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I'm going to give...
pick me.
Jim another spirit.
Oh, yeah, we got there.
Add 4 mana total. Flashback this Faithless Looting.
By the way, chat, I only have 1 spirit token, so I'm not going to like represent the untapped one. One of them is untapped.
They're always going to hit me anyway, so what's the difference? Like, yep. Even untap them.
I want to point out something really funny. Jim's been streaming so much that he just said, by the way, chat.
He did.
I only have 1 spirit token.
Yeah.
Okay, chat, what do we got here? What do we got going on?
Let us know in the chat what we should do.
Spot weakness.
Spot weakness. Identify... shortcomings.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, detect defects.
Okay, yeah. So I am discarding this Chaos Warp and this Regrowth.
Ooh.
To my Faithless Looting. Then I'm going to play this Basic Forest as my land for turn, and then tapping that Basic Forest, I'm going to cast a Mana Crypt.
You can.
Yeah. Right. Mm-hmm.
And, am I attacking?
Yeah, punch Jim.
I'm going to attack Alex.
Attack Jim with your ape.
For two?
Yeah.
We got to get this Kaza out of here, Elliot.
What does that Kaza do?
Literally
does
just it taps do? For one.
Yeah. It's going to get worse.
Where X is the number of wizards you control. Yeah, that's that's pretty good.
Pretty good.
I like control a singular wizard.
Yeah.
Jan literally just explained to us how good it is with X spells in his deck when he can copy them.
I did. That is true.
Yep, yep, yep.
If you want to scrub back in the stream.
That's okay. I'm gonna pass the turn.
Drop. Okay. I'm gonna tap five.
Did you gain your life, Jim?
I don't because I
don't have you don't have heart effects anymore.
Then I'm gonna cast Chandra Torch of Defiance.
Whoa.
Good card.
Yeah. I have no offense.
That resolve, yeah. So I will immediately...
Oh,
Jen, you got an effect?
Yeah, that's all good. Yeah, it's
all okay.
Good. I'm going to plus it.
Which one?
Hang on.
Card's good.
Card is good.
Yeah.
I'll plus it to add two mana to my mana pool.
Cool.
Two red. And I will pay another red. Paying three to cast Overflowing Chalice or Everflowing Chalice kicked once.
Sorry, Everflowing Chalice.
Yeah, one to cast the Everflowing Chalice. I'm kicking it once for two, so it's going to enter with one counter.
Yep.
And then.
You have one floating.
No, I don't.
No, you don't. I'm good at math.
Then I'm going to pass the turn.
Okay.
All right, big plays, Alex.
I really hope so. Oh, come back.
Come back. Get back.
There we go. Ouch, my face. Go to 22. Oh, no. We're almost in a standard game. The worst possible thing.
I actually just realized, too, right? Alex has this Angel's Grace under his Isochron Scepter. How are we actually killing him?
Well, you have to kill him on one of our turns and then kill him again on someone else's turn.
Yep.
Before he gets to attack.
We'll cast Argivingian Find.
Argivingian.
Return target.
Artifact related?
Artifact or enchantment from your graveyard to your hand.
Right.
Oh, yeah, that's one.
Looks like a Helm of the Host back in your grip, pal. No thanks.
Just scoop that back up. And I think we're just going to leave it there. We're not going to leave it there. We're going to attack Chandra.
Yeah, no blocks.
Chandra.
We'll pass.
Okay. Sweet.
Didn't want to cast the Helm. Interesting.
Yeah, I'll take another four.
Ooh. Jan's drawing too many cards. Stop that.
So it'd be one thing if I was drawing them and then casting them all, but I'm not. So
I mean, give you another turn, I guess?
Yeah, just calm down. Why can't everyone just let me cast my spells?
We would if you actually cast them. What do you got going on?
Seems bad for us.
Well, I guess I will take a pain and we'll cast Kalamax.
That's a creature spell.
Because you guys all got three threes.
Yeah, true.
And then I'll scry one. Well, I knew what that card was. Get out of here, card. And
wow, that's actually strong.
Yeah, then I'm gonna pass the turn.
That's nice. Untap. Bop, bop. Bop, 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 bop. Evens take damage off of this crypt. Ooh, take some damage. Go to 33. Draw for my turn. Oof. That card's not very good right now. Kalamax is a 4/4.
Correct.
Rough.
Leave me alone.
You can't.
I needed a blocker.
You can't make me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will recast Wurt the Raid Mother. Thoughts, questions, concerns.
I have concerns.
You got it.
Yeah, I have no effects.
I'll make two more gobos. Go to combat. Maybe it's like, well, it doesn't even kill him, right? I guess it just keeps him casting Angel's Grace. Ah, whatever. Uh-huh. Attack Alex for three. Pass the turn.
Okay. I will untap. Draw. Play this land. Gonna plus Chandra to exile the top card of my library.
Pretty good.
It is Rite of Flame.
Ooh. Wow. It's like you plus one Chandra to plus one Chandra.
Well, no, not even, because it cost me two mana to cast it. So I'm not going to cast it, and you can each take two.
Yep.
Each, wow.
Each fun. Take two. So that's Chandra's real good.
Yeah, what the heck.
It's definitely the best of those impulse effects.
Mm-hmm. It's pretty good, yeah. Especially since it's a plus. Like, wow.
It's a plus, yeah. It doesn't target. There's like just, I played a ton of Chandra in like other formats, and this Chandra's just so good.
Rings of Bright Hearth.
Oh no, that doesn't seem good for us either.
Well, not for you two anyway.
Then I'm going to move to combat.
Mm-hmm.
And I will attack Alex for one. And I'll pass the turn.
Okie dokie. Let's see if my mana crypt's going to keep killing me. It won't. All right.
For now.
For now.
For now.
All right. Y'all ain't going to believe this.
Play your planes.
It's a Battlefield Forge.
Oh, he's got one red.
He's got a single red mana.
Now, let me tell you how much I need to, because it's a lot.
Is it precisely six mana's worth of needing it?
Yeah. And Helm of the Host.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think we're actually going to pass.
All right. Untap. Take one off of... Should put some life gain in this deck.
Feed the clans. Your Kalamax is ferocious and it's an instant. Ooh, baby.
Copy. Okay. There you go.
I'm not gonna pay anything off this silver. I'm gonna play this land. I'm drawing lands.
Hi, drawing lands. I am Elliot.
Hi, Elliot.
Good night, lands. Everybody.
Good night, stream.
How do you be out there even making the dad jokes to the dad?
Internet magic was a mistake.
The spike of hitters was a mistake.
At least if we were in the world headquarters, we could reach over and smack you.
True.
Yeah, I'm going to re-put those back like that, because then I'm going to scry and put this useless spell to the bottom.
Seems good.
Okay. Let's start. Elliot, do you want a flyer?
Do I want a flyer? Yeah, sure, I'll take one. Yeah.
Like if I gave you like a 3/3 flyer, would you be cool with that?
Maybe? I don't
know. That's sweet.
Oh, okay. I get it. That's not good for me.
Yeah, all right. Okay, I'm going to cast a Gilded Drake.
Yeah, that's sad. Yeah. Novex.
Yeah, okay, I'm going to do the old switcheroo with...
Hang on, I have a response.
Oh.
Okay.
I'm going to pay 3 mana. To a braid wart dealing damage.
Yep. I have no effects.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, wart's dead. I'll put her back in the command zone.
That's all I really cared about.
Yeah, fair enough.
It's a pretty good braid, Jim.
Yeah, I don't need Jan minusing Ral and conspiring a spell to cast it 3 times.
Four times with this.
Four times with Kalamax. Yeah, I definitely don't need that happening on my watch.
That's fair. I mean, okay. Pass the turn. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to pass.
I will untap. Evens damage. Oof. Crypt does not like me.
I have you all on crypt clocks.
Yeah, actually, though. I'm at 28. Draw for my turn. Hmm. Well, that card sucks with things that Alex has in play. Things being Vrynwingmere.
Oh, okay.
Exclusively.
Well, if you give me some spirits, like...
Well, if you give me... That's what you sound like.
Yeah, that's true.
Is it?
Oh, okay. I was there, yeah.
Well, if you'd give me some spirits.
Alex using his talents to make him not...
Actually, I think at that point it's Wiles.
Red. One, two, three, four.
His charisma.
I don't have any of that. I only have a couch-risma.
Hmm.
What even is couch-risma?
Couch-risma sounds like a breakfast cereal.
I hate everything.
With new healthy couch-risma, you can get a balance.
Stop! Stop it. This is like
play a
really...
card.
Oh, shut up. I can't because you have a stupid Vrynwingmere in play, asshole. Shut up. Keep killing my wort, too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. She costs 10, though. That's crazy.
Would you have rather Jan had it?
No, no. That was a pretty good outcome, all things considered. Okay, so... Oh, I didn't name a color when my Utopia Sprawl came into play, and I just realized that, but I named red. Everybody be cool.
That is actually how we'd handle it under the rules, so you're good.
Perfect. Yeah, you got it.
You're fine.
So, one here, two, three, four, five.
Mm-hmm.
I have to pay 5 mana for this Past in Flames. Each instant and sorcery card in my graveyard gains flashback equal to their mana cost.
Yeah, I have no effects.
It's good.
Oh, yeah. Go for it.
Cool. I would like to add 2 red and attempt to pyroblast Kalamax.
Feels good.
Okay. I'm gonna dispel your pyroblast.
Okay.
Trigger Ral Elliot ticket damage.
Okay. Go to 27.
Why does that trigger Ral? Did you double it?
I cast a spell. Yeah, it's whenever you cast or copy.
Yeah, oh, okay. It is cast or copy. Yeah. Jim, you can make another spirit. I'm going to add a red. I'm going to...
Hold tight, just for a hot second. Won't Kalamax also copy the dispel?
No, it's not tapped.
It's not tapped.
Oh, right.
Yeah, Jim makes a spirit out of red. Red Elemental Blast, targeting Ral Storm Conduit.
Interesting. I don't know how much I care about that. Yeah, that's fine.
Cool. I will move to combat and attack Alex for 3.
I'll block.
Oh!
Interesting.
Pass the turn.
Okay, I'll untap. I feel like a weight has been lifted.
Sure wish he'd... Maybe I should have talked to him about it. I could have maybe convinced him to do it before casting all my spells.
Oh, man. This is sweet. Oh, actually, I do gain a life in my upkeep because I had 3 artifacts.
Yep.
Now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to plus Chandra and pay 2 to copy it with Rings of Bright Hearth.
Oh,
which one are you picking?
Exile the top card.
Okay.
So first one is going to be Tormenting Voice. Second one is going to be Wheel of Fortune.
Whoa.
Or I guess I have to resolve these one at a time, right?
Yes, you do.
Yes.
Yeah, I do. Because it requires me to cast it during...
The resolution.
Yeah.
During the resolution. Yeah, I'll cast Tormenting Voice.
Mm-hmm.
And discard Direfleet Daredevil to do it. Okay. To draw two cards.
Did you pay three for the Tormenting Voice?
I don't need to.
Oh, right, yeah.
I'll draw two cards. And then the second resolution, I'm going to exile a mountain. I can't cast it, so it'll deal two to each opponent.
Mm-hmm. 14.
25.
16.
Yikes.
I haven't played a land yet for this turn. I am going to tap four and cast Karkklan Ironworks.
Mm. Oh. That's a good card.
I'm going to take one off of this Waterlogged Grove. I'm going to mana drain the Karkklan Ironworks.
Seems good.
Seems
sponsors
strong.
To the mana drain?
Yeah, no effects, unfortunately.
Not the rings, Jim. Not the rings.
Oh, sorry. Yeah.
The power.
That's gone. And I'm going to exile Simeon Spirit Guide.
Mm-hmm.
To cast this Chromatic Sphere.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll pass the turn.
Alrighty. Untap. Show me an odd number. That's not an odd number.
Damn, I should have attacked, but oh well.
No, you should not have. This was a good choice.
I have so many creatures now.
You should have attacked. We all should have attacked. I'm really hoping I didn't misdo my math. And yeah, okay, good.
I'll cast Grand Abolisher.
No effects.
I'll equip Grand Abolisher with Helm of the Host.
Yeah, I like that. Make some blockers.
Additional Grand Abolisher.
Yep.
Alrighty, that's the turn, as they say in the business.
All right, that was a heck of a turn.
Hold on.
Put them back like that. Because I'm not only.
I was really hoping for that Wheel of Fortune to go.
It's in his hand now, isn't it?
Yep.
Yeah, I was saving my. I'm going to make four colorless.
It is indeed the only card in my hand.
Okay, four colorless. Led two blue, and I will cast a Teferi, Master of Time.
Mm. Yeah.
Which Teferi is that?
You may activate loyalty abilities Teferi, Master of Time on any player's turn anytime you could cast an instant. I can plus one to draw a card, then discard a card. I can minus three to phase out target creature I don't control. And I can minus 10 to take two extra turns after this one.
Right. Okay.
It starts at three loyalty, and it's plus one, minus three, and minus two.
Mm-hmm. Seems strong.
Then I'm going to plus to draw a card and then discard a card. So, I don't even know anymore. I guess I'm going to discard this Merchant Scroll. No, that's bad. Because I have mana floating. Discard Fluster Storm. Cast Merchant Scroll.
You got a Merchant Scroll.
Okay, I'm going to get this Frantic Search. This one right here. Put it into my hand.
Isn't that what you just did?
No, so I Merchant Scroll.
Oh, sorry. I thought it was a Frantic Search.
Frantically Merchant Search.
There we go.
So I'm going to let this mana drain. I'm going to go to combat.
Mm-hmm.
And let's attack. Stack Elliot.
Does he have trample? He doesn't have trample, does he?
No.
Oh, quad block him, Elliot.
Quad block him. Do it.
He's just going to cast a spell.
He might berserk it.
Yeah.
Well, no, he's going to
cast. If you don't block, I might berserk and just kill you.
He's going to cast literally any spell and give it a counter. Yeah. I'm going to block it with a single goblin.
Yeah, sounds good. Yeah, that's smart. Second main phase.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah.
Cast Frantic Search. Mm-hmm. Copied with Kalamax.
Yep.
Draw two. Untap these three lands. Oh, no. I didn't want these to be good cards.
Oh, what do I do with all these good cards?
Yeah, tell me more. What's it like?
Okay, yeah, I guess I'm going to discard a Soul Ring and a Dual Caster Mage.
Yikes.
And then I'm going to float a blue. Draw two. Discard a Pact of Negation and an Oko Thief of Crowns.
Yikes.
I know. Cast Ponder.
You had a Ponder.
Top three. Huh.
Hey, Jim.
Hi.
What you thinking about?
Thinking about whether I want to cast this spell or not.
What did you tap to pay for Ponder?
He had a mana floating.
Blue I had floating.
Okay, cool.
From my two Frantic Searches.
Yeah, I remember that now.
Good talk.
Goob.
Cast Spellseeker.
That's a good one, too. I have no effects.
Okay, I'm going to get pulled from tomorrow.
You got it.
And then pass turn.
Alrighty, untap. Flip for this mana crypt or roll for this mana crypt. Evens damage. Odds. No damage for me.
Seems good.
Seems strong, yeah. I will draw for my turn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'll tap this mana crypt for this Grim Monolith. And then I'll tap 10 mana.
Ooh.
Yeah, give Jim another spirit, I guess.
I don't think Jim needs any more spirits.
Well, whatever.
He's got 35 life, too.
Wow.
Yeah.
Cast this wart, make two more goblins. Now I'll go to combat, I guess. Ape at Teferi.
This is a good attack.
What? This genre is going to kill us all.
I don't care.
I mean, like, it's objectively true. This is not a bad attack, but it's objectively true to Sean.
So are you blocking, Jen?
The Sean is going to kill us on his turn?
Two more.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Two more turns, yeah.
I don't think the Chandra is scary right now. I think this Teferi is scary.
Yeah, I'm going to block
this. This Teferi is scary.
Okay. Dark side down.
Yep.
This Teferi is scary. It would be a great Halloween song.
Yep, pass turn.
End of your turn, I'm going to take up Teferi.
Okay.
Discard Autumn's Veil.
Tap. Draw. I'm going to minus three Chandra and copy it with Rings of Bright Hearth.
Oh, yeah.
Both are going at Kalamax. So 8 damage total.
Do you want to tick your Chandra down to two?
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure he doesn't want to, but he should.
Should is the key word there, yeah.
Sure. Okay. Then I'll move to combat.
Mm-hmm.
And attack Teferi with five spirits and an ape.
Yeah, okay. So before blocks, I'm going to minus three, and I'm going to phase out Dockside Extortionist.
Okay.
And then Teferi will take eight.
Okay. I am going to tap three and cast Wheel of Fortune.
Oh, yeah. That one's kind of sad for me.
So I'm discarding Karn, Scion, and Urza.
Alex?
Ooh, that's a good one.
So,
I'm getting ready to pull for tomorrow.
Ooh, I'm discarding Bonus Round, Transmogrify, and Reality Scramble.
I'm going to tap one, sacrifice Chromatic Sphere to add a red and draw a card.
Okay. You got it.
One red floating. So rude. Still no lands.
Ouch. Yikes.
I'm going to cast Chromatic Star. Then I am really hoping I draw a land here. Oh, I still have my red floating, so I'm going to use the red to activate Chromatic Star to make a red and draw a card.
You got it.
So I have one red floating.
No land.
No land.
Call it.
Call it.
I'm going to use my red floating and cast Goblin Welder.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah,
I'm going to misstep a Goblin Welder.
Oh. Okay.
Then I'm 12. Going to pay another red and cast Gorilla Shaman.
What?
That's fine.
He baited you.
Not really.
And then I'll pass the turn.
End of your turn because Alex has a pair of Grand Abolishers.
Yes, yes.
I'm going to pay a red, tap Kazar, and
for two.
Cast Thrill of Possibilities, discarding a Steam Vents.
Yep.
Draw two.
Seems one. Good.
Yep. Carry on, Alex.
Right on. One tap. For an odd number. That's an odd number. Alrighty. Man, it is so nice playing with a mitt full of actual stuff.
Okay. Yeah, I'm not happy about this.
Play this Clifftop Retreat.
Uh-oh. Did we die?
I don't think he has enough to cast Aurelia and equip it.
I hope he's one short.
Yeah,
I did the math. He's one short. He can like probably kill me if he wanted to.
You are at 13.
I'm at 13.
Spellseeker blocks one of the other guys. That leaves me in too vulnerable position.
Yeah, it's not like not a great idea to kill me, but he can.
Yeah. All right. We're gonna start off with playing this here Mother of Runes. Pay two for Felwar Stone.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, why didn't he do all of this before? I was like, oh yeah, we just
didn't have any
Wheel of Fortune. Yeah.
Wheel. All right.
We're actually going to move Helm of the Host over to Mother of Runes.
Oh, interesting.
Seems good.
Yeah. And then we'll go to combat, make another Mother of Runes.
Mm-hmm.
Jim, you are tapped out and have a Gorilla Shaman?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. We are going to give our token Grand Abolisher protection from red and swing into Chandra.
Okay. No blocks.
Okie dokie. You're welcome, Jim.
I would say Chandra put in plenty of work.
Yeah,
does not owe me anything at this point.
Yeah. That being said, I think I am going to pass my turn.
Cool. Tap.
Mm-hmm.
Take one off of my Mana Vault. Draw three for Sylvan Library. Don't put those two back. Draw this one. Alright, so I'm going to play a Flooded Strand as land for turn.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm going to crack this Flooded Strand, going down to 11 with Alex. Wait, I'm going to get a Volcanic Island. Then I'm going to add a green and a blue. And I'm going to cast a Growth Spiral. So draw a card. And then I'm going to play this Misty Rainforest from my hand. And then I'm going to tap this Tropical Island and cast a Mystic Remora.
Oh.
And from there, I will pass the old turn.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty. I will untap everything but this Grim Monolith, because that would be cheating.
None of us could actually stop you.
Haha, true. Untap. And in my upkeep, evens damage. No damage. Draw four turn. So I'm going to tap this Mana Crypt.
Yeah.
And then floating a colorless, I'm going to cast this Soul Ring.
Okay.
Jan can draw a card. Yep.
Oh, sweet. Yeah.
Then I'm going to add two colorless. So I go up to three, go up to five colorless. I'll add a green with the Taiga, which will add a red because of the Utopia Sprawl.
Yep.
Okay.
So floating a green, and using one of those, I'm going to cast Desperate Ritual. Jan can draw a card. Any effects?
Nope.
Okay. So I'm going to make three red. Then I'm going to use a red and four colorless to cast or flashback this Past in Flames from my graveyard. Mm-hmm. Jan can draw a card.
Do it.
So my instants and sorceries have flashback.
Hang on, I might have a response to Past in Flames.
Sure.
You have, what do you have floating right now?
Two red and a green.
Two red and a green, and you have access. So you have access to six mana. Mm-hmm. Past in Flames cost four.
Past in Flames costed five. To flash it back.
Yeah. That's fine.
Okay. I am going to cast with a red and a green. So I just have a red floating. This Hull Breach. And I am going to conspire two of the goblin tokens.
So you get two Hull Breaches.
Two Hull Breaches on the stack.
Okay.
Targets. I don't know how it works with you drawing a card, because you don't for the copy.
I don't for the copy. If you blow up my Mr. Gamora, I still think I draw for the first trigger.
Yeah, yep. I think so as well.
So what are you targeting?
So the first one is going to target Mystic Remora and Isochron Scepter.
And what's the copy target? So that's the copy?
Sure.
The copy's going to resolve first.
Yeah, that one. Yeah, whichever one is resolving first.
You got to choose both targets or all the targets before Jan draws anything.
Okay, so the copy will target Mystic Remora, Isochron Scepter. The other one will target Sylvan Library, Helm of the Host.
Nice. This is a good play.
I have no effects.
I will... activate Angel's Grace.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
These are both going to the yard, right?
Yeah. Hullbreach is exiled because...
I assume, Alex, just in the terms of optimal sequencing, you're doing it after the Mystic Remora is popped? Okay.
I assumed so.
He can't because I targeted it first. It was with the.
Oh yeah, it's in.
They were targeted at the same time.
Oh yeah. Okay. That's so yeah, then Jan will draw another card.
Okay. Draw another card.
Yeah, I did it.
So I will use that red, and this green, I guess, to cast this Arcane Signet. And then I will tap this Arcane Signet to put a wild growth on this stomping ground.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
And then I will play a Havenwood Battlegrounds tapped as my land for turn.
Okay.
Pass.
Okay.
My Dockside Extortionist phase is back in.
Yep. Ooh.
Okay. So I will draw.
You also gain a life.
I do gain a life.
Am I counting right? One, two, three. Yeah.
Yep.
I'm going to pay four. and cast this Aetherflux Reservoir.
Yeah.
Where's your Hull Breach now, Elliot?
Yeah. Exiled.
Exiled.
Yep.
Great.
Then I'm going to move to combat, and I'll attack Jan with five spirits.
Yeah, I'll go to block. I will block one of them with Kaza.
Block one of them?
Yeah, she's a 1-2.
Okay.
I will take 4.
So you go down to 7. Second main, I'm going to cast Ichor Wellspring and gain 2 life.
Yeah.
Draw a card. Mm-hmm. Play this Gemstone Caverns as my land for turn. Finally drew a land after drawing like 12 cards.
And it's a Gemstone Caverns, just to rub it in.
It's fine.
Hey?
It doesn't matter. Yeah. I'm going to cast this Expedition Map, gain 3.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm going to cast this Codex Shredder, gain 4.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to cast this Pyrite Spell Bomb, gain 5.
Uh-oh.
That's Xaxxes.
Then I'm going to pass the turn.
Yeah. End of your turn, because I can't do anything on Alex's turn. I'm going to crack this Misty Rainforest and go to 6. All right, so I'm going to get a snow-covered island. And then, because we can, we're going to go red.
Embercleave.
Yeah. Kaza is going to be 2. I'll go with that. We are going to Electro Dominance. X is going to equal 3. Maintain priority. Add a red. Reverberate the Electro Dominance.
So we're getting rid of this treasure?
Yeah, I'm getting rid of this treasure.
Okay. So reverberate X equals 3 on, or sorry, Electro Dominance X equals 3 twice?
Yeah.
Okay.
Targets. So the copy. Okay. So targets, I'm going to deal 3 to Jim and 3. Yeah, I'm going to target Jim with 1 and I'm going to target Wart with the other.
Okay.
And then the first Electro Dominance. So the copy off that, I'm going to cast Grape Shot. The storm count.
Can you choose a target before you cast more spells?
I did.
He did. He targeted you.
I targeted them. I targeted you and I targeted Wart.
I was thinking it was Expansion Explosion.
No. So Electro Dominance, part of the resolution. First one's going to cast Grape Shot. So the first one will go at Jim for 3. And then Grape Shot should be 8 damage.
Jim cast Aetherflux Reservoir, Ichor Spring, 3, 4.
Then I cast,
and then you cast
2, so storm 6, count is 7.
Yep.
So I will do I will do 2 to Jim's dockside, and then I'll do 6 to Jim. So Jim's taking 9 off this. And his dock side's dying.
Okay.
Then, so that's the copy. So then for the real one, the spell, I'm going to cast off of it. So Wart's going to take 3, and then I'm going to cast a Wheel of Fortune.
Oh.
Okay.
All right, Wart is dead again.
You caught a Sigarda's Aid, a Chaos Warp, a Spirit, an Expedition, and a Spectator City.
Okay, I've got Goblin, Matron, and Manifold Key.
Scalding Tarn, Snow-Covered Island, Wooded Foothills, Narset's Reversal, and Mystical Tutor.
Hickory Woodlot Mountain Tree of Tales.
Alright. And yeah, I will be done.
Okay. My turn. Sounds good. Alrighty. We're gonna hope for some odd. It's even. Going to 8. Much less comfy now that I don't have my immortality trick up.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see here. Play this Plains for the turn. Tap our Felwar Stone for this Sol Ring. Tap our Sol Ring for this Talisman of Conviction. We're going to pay 6, taking a pain. Going to 7.
Thanks.
For Aurelia. While everyone's tapped out.
Yep. Seems good.
Yep. I mean, yeah. You still have your Grand Abolishers. So.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's a fair point. Mm-hmm. I'd like to go to combat.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. I'd
like to attack Jan.
Oh, yeah.
Trigger Aurelia.
Trigger Aurelia. I'd like to attack Jan for 3.
Yep, I'm dead.
Okay. Right. Alex, do you want to just move your dice onto your Grand Abolisher and your Mother of Runes to indicate you have 2 of them? Two each.
Two of them. 2, Alex. Yep. Love you.
I'm sorry. It is tough for me sometimes. From there, what we'll do is we'll pay 3. Rule of Law.
Oh.
Rule of Law is aggressive.
Yeah. Rule of Law.
Mm-hmm.
And then we will pass our turn.
Okay. I will untap. Oh, everything but the Grim Monolith. Still not cheating.
I believe you.
Thank you. God, everything has stuff on him now. This Stomping Ground is Utopia Sprawled. No, Wild Growth, and the Taiga is Utopia Sprawled, and there's these things. Okay. These untap. It is hard out here, actually. You got a good point there, Alex. Okay. Upkeep. Evens damage for the Mana Crypt. 4. I will take damage down to 22. And I will draw for my turn. And since there's a rule of law in play, I guess we'll just do this the hard way. Huh, Alex?
Approved.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
What?
Tooth and nail entwined.
Oh crap.
No.
Okay. Yeah, that'll do.
Yeah, I got no response to that.
Any effects, Alex?
All right. In response to Tooth and Nail, I'll pay 2 for Containment Priest.
Mm. Ooh, that's powerful.
Get contained.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's unfortunate. I have no effects to Containment Priest.
Okay.
So I will search my library. So off of Tooth and Nail, I will search my library for 2 creatures, a Kiki Jiki Mirror Breaker, and a Zealous Conscripts, and put them into my hand. And then I will choose to not put any creatures from my hand into play.
Seems good.
That is a choice.
Yep, it's the fine part. It's search and then put onto the battlefield from your hand are the 2 abilities.
Okay. After you choose Entwine, don't you have to put stuff on the battlefield?
It's up to 2.
Yeah, it's up to 2.
Oh, up to 2. Cool.
I will play this Sandstone Needle tapped with 2 depletion counters on it.
Depletion?
Depletions.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Go to discard. Discard this Carpet of Flowers that I can never cast.
Okay.
Well, you can cast it.
Nope, 1 spell.
I'll untap. I'll gain a life. Draw a card for my turn. This is mega interesting. I'm going to cycle Forgotten Cave.
Yep,
you got it.
I think I'm just going to cast Sensei's Divining Top.
Seems good.
Then I'm just going to pass the turn.
Okay. I have an effect in your end step because it is when I'm allowed to cast a spell. It will be a thrill of possibility. As an additional cost, I will discard this basic mountain.
Seems good.
Okay, I'm going to respond. I'm going to pop Alex's Chrome Mox for 1 mana using Gorilla Shaman's ability.
Seems good.
May I draw 2 cards?
Yep.
Yoink. Oh, good. 2 lands.
Alrighty. We're going to untap. We are going to... Oh! Find one of our cards out of shape. Oh boy. All right. So need to roll an odd number. We rolled an odd number. Right.
Disaster.
Better lucky than good, right? We're going to actually draw a card for turn this turn. And be smart about that. So we'll play a red off of Felwar Stone. Two from Mana Crypt. For Blood Moon.
Ooh.
Oh my.
Yeah, I've got a lot of non-basics.
Do I want to respond to... I can't because of Grand Abolisher. Never mind.
Yeah.
Blood Moon happens.
Sorry, what ability do you want to activate?
An Inventor's Fair?
Yeah.
Grand Abolisher doesn't do anything to lands.
Yeah. Do I want to find something off of Inventor's Fair is the question.
More like Inventor's Unfair.
I am going to crack Inventor's Fair. Off of the Inventor's Fair, I'm going to get Basalt Monolith.
Okay. Seems good. Elliot, any other interaction with Blood Moon?
No effects.
All right, that'll resolve. So all non-basic lands are mountains.
This Utopia Sprawl falls off of my Taiga.
Oh, yeah. Good catch.
Yep.
I think we're going to start with... Jim, you don't have any flying blockers, do you?
That's correct.
Okay. In that case, I'm going to shortcut both combats and deal 6 to you. Barking yep. You with 6
command. No blocks.
Alrighty. I actually think that's it. That's all for me. Did I play a land this turn? Don't think I did, so I'll go ahead and play this Maze of Ith.
Seems good.
Mm-hmm. And from there, we're going to pass the turn.
I will untap. All of these basic mountains. Wow, one of them has a wild growth on it, though.
That's enchant land.
Yeah.
So.
All right.
You got there.
Wow, I can tap this Forbidden Orchard without giving somebody a spirit. Insane.
Non-token.
Are you?
Oh done? Wait, I'm sorry. I thought you were referring to Containment Priest.
I wasn't.
Sorry.
Okay. Upkeep, Mana Crypt, evens damage. Oh, no damage. Very strong. Nice. Draw for turn. Kill my library. Meow. What does this do? I'm going to play this Windswept Heath, which is a mountain. And pass the turn.
Okay. I'll untap. Draw. That card is entirely dead. I'm going to spin top. Yep. Should have done that on your end step, Elliot, but I didn't.
Fair, reasonable.
And instead, I drew a totally dead card. Put him back like that. Okay, well, I will tap 3 and cast this Basalt Monolith.
Yeah.
Gain 1 life.
I will gain 1 life. Okay, so I would like to activate Basalt Monolith to make 3 mana.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I will activate Basalt Monolith's ability to untap itself, holding priority, paying 2 more mana to activate Rings of Bright, or to pay for Rings of Bright Hearth's trigger.
Sure.
You got it.
I would like to repeat that loop to generate infinite colorless mana.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Alex, I would like to activate Gorilla Shaman to pop your Talisman and your Sol Ring and your Felwar Stone. Is that good? Can you guys hear me?
Yep.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, sorry.
I was just trying to see if I wanted to do anything.
Okay, yeah.
Took care of it. So Sol Ring, Felwar Stone, Talisman.
Yep. Good. Elliot, I would like to pop your Grim Monolith. I would also like to pop my Ichor Wellspring to draw a card.
Ooh.
Play a mountain for my turn.
Okay.
I'll spin top.
Mm-hmm.
Gonna put that one on top. I guess I'll activate Expedition Map to search for a land. Put it Sounds into good. Play. Or put it into my hand. Gonna get this Buried Ruin. 6, 7, 8, 9. I have to discard 2 cards. I'm going to discard Quicksmith Genius and Pyroblast. And I'll pass the turn.
In your end step. I'm going to cast Where, targeting my own mana crypt.
Ugh. I hate to see it.
Do you want to also cast Terror, targeting your own rule of law?
Yeah. Do nope. that.
I'm going to respond by spinning top.
Okay.
I'll put them back like this. Why didn't I cast Bosh when I had infinite mana? I could have
maybe cast Assault Monolith.
Oh, right, right, right. Yeah. Cast Bosh next turn.
Yep.
Yeah, I'll pass priority on where.
Yep. Sounds good. Yep. Okie dokie. Jim, we're going to have you take another 6.
Yep. A blocks. 12 Aurelia damage.
Indeed. Tap 2 for Aether Sworn Canonist.
Additional rules of law.
We'll pass turn.
Alrighty, I will untap. Everything is untapped. Upkeep evens damage for the Mana Crypt. No damage. Draw for my turn. Alrighty. Well, whatever. We ain't getting any younger then, huh? I guess. Play this Spire Garden, which is a mountain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Cast this Zealous Conscripts.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. Any effects?
No.
Alex.
I'm good.
All right. When it ETBs and triggers, I will target Aurelia, the war leader.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
What's it do again?
I will steal it.
All right, I'll just hand that down to you. Goes which direction? Yep. This direction?
You don't want to just tap a Mother of Runes to give it protection from red?
Okay, fine.
We got him. We tapped down one of his Mother of Runes.
Well, yeah. I was like, if you don't, you die. So
yeah.
yeah. Pass the turn.
Okay. I'll untap. Draw a card. Okay. So I'm going to demonstrate the same loop that I did last turn.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I'm sorry, what loop?
Activate Basalt Monolith.
Just go ahead.
Okay, so that taps two of my lands. I've got infinite colorless mana. I'd like to cast Bosh.
Yeah.
Bosh.
I would like to activate Bosh's ability.
In response to Bosh, I'm going to give Aurelia protection from red once again.
Okay. I'm going to activate Bosh's ability, sacrificing itself to deal 8 damage to Alex.
My face.
Yep.
Isn't it 6? Is it 6?
No, it's 8.
He's 8. Oh, yeah.
It's CMC, it's not power. Wow, that's crazy.
CMC. I think this is the end.
Yep.
Jim, you just win.
So now I would like to cast Bosh.
Yep.
Sacrifice it, deal 8 to Elliot. Yep. Cast Bosh, deal another 8. Cast Bosh, deal another 8.
Wait.
Rule of laws are gone, yeah.
Yeah, rule of laws are gone. Okay, so wait.
Okay, so hurry. So,
sorry, cast Bosh again.
Okay, hang on. Where do you want to back up to?
Cast Bosh again.
The second time?
Sure.
Okay. Okay.
Jim, gain 3 life.
Oh, yeah, right.
It wasn't going to be relevant. You're just going to, if you could just kill Elliot, but he's got stuff to do.
So Elliot wants to respond to the second Bosh cast.
Okay. I'm going to sacrifice this emergence zone so that I can cast spells this turn as though they had flash.
Okay.
I'm going to flash in Kiki Jiki. I'm going to remove a depletion counter from Sandstone Needle to do that.
Hang on. That's fine. Go ahead and do that.
Okay. Kiki Jiki ETBs. I would like to tap Kiki Jiki, targeting Zealous Conscripts.
I would like to respond to that by tapping a red and sacrificing Pirate Spell Bomb to pop Kiki Jiki.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, seems good.
Oh, no.
Yeah, strong.
And I'll also double it with Rings of Bright Hearth to target one of your goblins.
Dead guy. Yeah, yeah, that's cool. Yeah, I don't think I had it out.
Okay. So I would like to attempt to do...
Does the target resolve? Wait, yeah, I targeted him, right?
So the Pirate's Pilgrim happens first. Yeah. Then the Kiki Jiki activation is on the stack, so you have a Zealous Conscript coming into play.
Okay, yeah. When it enters, I'll target...
Gorilla Shaman?
It doesn't actually do anything, though, right?
Doesn't actually do.
He's already got Infinite Colorless. Yeah, whatever. I'm dead! You got me.
That's a good effort.
Right? It might have been. I had like 100 other ways to do that. Because with infinite mana, I can also draw my deck with Sensei's Divining Top. And then I can just...
You also gain, and you gain, I can cloud key,
make a bunch of thing, and then Aetherflux you.
Yeah. Man, I thought I had an out, but I did not.
That was a fun game.
Yeah, for those of you at home, like our patrons will know that that game took 2 hours and 15 minutes to play. But if you're not a patron, it took 2 hours and 15 minutes to play. We released the full version of this to our patrons. So you can see it uncut. You can see what we talk about or do while we cut. And yeah. So what did you, do you guys have any thoughts about the game itself? Any things you might have done differently? What was holding you back?
I apparently need to play more like destroy target thing effects and less guttural responses.
That's fair. Jim, are you missing us on face cams?
Oh, yeah. True.
Yeah. And honestly, I don't think you're wrong about running it the way you're running it. Just this pod is so off meta for CEDH.
Yeah.
I have so many. Like destroy target things effects. I had like the only one I saw that game was the Hull Breach and the Chaos Warp that I discarded. But like going through my deck, right? Like I have like Mog Salvage here. I have whatchamacallit? Nature's Claim, Artifact Mutation. I have like Croson Grip.
Yeah, I
think it
can you guys see me okay?
Yeah, we can see you. Okay. Yeah.
My screen froze and I can't see any of you.
Oh, okay. Well, we're all still here.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think I was like a turn behind on most of the stuff I wanted to do, but it is what it is. Like,
that Vryn Wingmare effect shut me down so hard. Like, everything that I want to be doing, and then also to a lesser extent, Jan's Mystic Remora, even though Elliot dealt with it right away, would have boned me big time because like I had this Cloud Key in my hand and I just wanted to cast a million things and go off with Aetherflux Reservoir, but yeah, it wasn't happening with either a Mystic Remora or Rule of Law or a Vryn Wingmare effect.
I got very, very lucky with the stacks pieces. I drew into Helm on turn one. And I drew into Vryn Wingmare on turn two after my opening. And I basically just got to sit there with Chekhov's gun of, oh, you're going to try and do something, but what if you don't?
So I could have killed Alex on Jim's end step, but it didn't do me any good. Like, there's no point for me to kill Alex. I also wasn't expecting Alex to kill me on his turn.
Honestly, I didn't. I was just sitting there going, what can I do that's anything?
I think it was correct. I think Jan was the best equipped to deal with Aurelia in that situation.
A couple times,
And like he definitely wasn't killing me. It would be four, like it's what a four turn clock to kill me, right?
Yeah,
yeah.
I don't think I was doing a ton at that point, but I didn't. I was at six life. I didn't think Alex was just going to kill me.
That was literally the only reason. It was just, can I get a player out of the game? Because it means there's one less draw against my draws.
Exactly. Yeah, and Jan has the most interaction in his deck because it's blue, right?
Well, and then because Rule of Law doesn't hurt your deck as much as it hurts their decks.
Right.
Because as much as they have some instant speed stuff, you're just instant speed stuff.
Right? Yep. Yeah. Yeah. So, let's call it there. So if you want to check out the full uncut version of this game, definitely sign up to our Patreon. There's going to be a link in the show notes. And let us know what you think of this format. Is there anything we can do better about this? I know this was a really long game, but if there's something that you think that we can do better, definitely let us know. Whether it's, you know, lighting or all that kind of stuff, I want to hear it in the show notes or in the comments. Let us know.
Constructive feedback is always appreciated.
Yeah, love it.
Yeah.
So, we'll call it there, and we'll catch you again in a couple weeks.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye.
Hey, thanks for checking out the Spike Feeders on YouTube. If you're not subscribed yet, make sure you click that subscribe button. And you can click this link to check out our other great videos.